floor before the king. What is it? What is wrong with my child? The king asked his wife in great anxiety. His wife replied, Igwe, please help my child. I think she is suffering from a severe food poisoning, Igwe. Igwe, dying, please help. Help, Igwe, please, our only child. And she burst loudly into tears. The king sighed heavily that one would hear the ground tremble. At this point, the king was thrown off balance, as this was the only child of the king, the one who would bear the throne, the heir to the throne. He was now very tense, with an intense rush of adrenaline. One who hasn't bought a child about losing an only child, we don't understand the level of disarray and pandemonium that happened in the village that day. Quickly, his chiefs advised him to send for the seer of the kingdom, as this would enable them to know the solution the gods had for them. Immediately, the king agreed, sent for his servant, ordered him immediately to go to the shrine and send for the seer. Immediately, the servant dashed out, ran out immediately to send for the seer. A once joyful kingdom, a once happy kingdom, now it has been thrown into disarray and pandemonium all over. What is it? This is the only child of the king, the only daughter of the king, the one who would bear the earth to the throne. What am I going to do? Gods of my forefathers, come to my aid, the king said. Not too long, the servants approached the palace with the seer. As she arrived the palace, she read the incantations to her God. She praised her God. She arrived the palace. She looked at the king, looked at the child, and smiled. Igwe, your child is going to die. That is what the gods have said. There is no solution, Igwe. You have offended the gods of your forefathers. Your child must die. Igwe, there is nothing I can do. Your child is going to die. After all, there is a solution after all. Listen attentively. Igwe, listen attentively. You must send for all the medical practitioners around your kingdom to come together to heal your dying child, lest she dies before sunset. The gods have spoken. But before I take my leave, queen, take this potion. Take it. It is a potion from Umuguna River. Use it. Massage your daughter from head to toe, so that her soul and body will stay together. This will only keep her for a few minutes, or probably some hours. Then she will die if these health practitioners don't come together. The God has spoken. Then she took her leave. Okay. There seems to be a solution after all. Help is coming after all. King said, okay, well, the gods have spoken. Now we now know what to do. We have to send for health practitioners around. Quickly, the chief decided to instruct or advise the king to help send for all the health practitioners. Immediately, the king agreed, sent for his servant, ordered his servant to come immediately to go around his kingdom, to send for all the medical practitioners to come immediately. Tell them the only child of the king is dying. Immediately, the servant dashed out, ran immediately to send for all the health practitioners. My dear, please, don't die. Don't die. This is my only child. Queen, I hope you are using the potion the seer gave to you. Please, what are you doing? Not too long, the medical doctor arrived.
The servant immediately arrived with a medical doctor. As she arrived, immediately she greeted the Igwe, then met the queen and asked, "What is wrong with your child, queen?" She replied, "She is suffering from food poisoning. Please help." Immediately she bent low and examined the child. She looked at the child, examined her thoroughly. "What is this? What infection is this? Could this be spirit? I don't even know. I don't know, Igwe. This is too much. This could be spiritual, Igwe. What is happening? I can't see her eyes. I can't see her pupil. She's... What? Ah. Igwe, there's nothing I can do, please. There's nothing I can do, Igwe. What is happening, Igwe? But I thought the God said when health practitioners come, solution will come. They almost gave up. Now the pharmacist arrived." She immediately greeted the king and asked the queen immediately, "What is wrong with your daughter? She is suffering from food poisoning. Please help."
Immediately she bent low,
examined the child. Poor pharmacist. She looked at the child. Is that what's happening? I can't seem to. What's this? What? I've never seen such a case before, she told the queen. Igwe, I don't know what this is. Please, this is for my 16 years of experience. I've not seen this before. Could this be spiritual? What is happening? Have you noticed what I'm saying? The medical doctor doesn't seem to agree with the presence of the pharmacist.
Rush, come on now.
Now this is getting serious. The palace is tensed, filled with discomfort and disarray. Everybody's sad. Is the doctor not supposed to work with the pharmacist? Are they not supposed to work together? It's not my business. Not too long, the religious man came. Just locked in. Approached the palace. When they came, like they knew something was wrong. They knew something was wrong. Perhaps they had seen a vision from God. Then they arrived. Immediately they greeted the Igwe. Met the Igwe, asked, "What is happening?" They felt it in their spirit to come to the palace. Immediately the Igwe explained to them what was happening. Then the religious men bent low and looked at the child and said, this is not spiritual now. This is not spiritual. This is a simple medical problem. Then they realized that the medical doctor was on one side, the pharmacist is on the other side. What is happening? These health practitioners are supposed to work together. When will this beach end? Then they decided to plead with the health practitioners individually. Beg with all they feared about. They beg in the name of God, in the name of all they serve. But that is not from God. After several minutes of plea and a lot of begging, they finally agreed. I thought God did it, the Igwe's child. Okay, now they have agreed to work together. Now the medical doctor looked closely. That is how it's supposed to be. Examine the child closely. So that, okay, I could actually write some good prescriptions to this. Immediately she wrote some prescriptions and gave it over to the pharmacist. The pharmacist now looked at this prescription. Okay. I didn't even reason it to that place. Now she opened her bag and dispensed this drug to the dying child. That is how it's supposed to be. A medical doctor is supposed to work hand in hand with the pharmacist, with the nurses, with all other health practitioners in the hospitals. Nobody is so superior over the other. The eyes need the nose need the mouth need all other parts of the body to function well. Then when they administered the drug to the child, they thought maybe there might be really no hope. Well, they've done their best. Well, at least record will now have it that they tried their best. But behold, after some minutes, people realized. Now regained their joy. They now became happy. All will agree with me now that unity in all spheres of life be overemphasized. Look at this great king from the east, yet he has a wife from the south, members of his royal cabinet from the north, and even from the west. A clear picture of unity and diversity. This king makes sure
If you love the people, can I, this is a better song about what does.